Now to this, stopping street racers with some bumps in the road. City officials in Compton are hoping the small fix will solve a big problem. KKL 9's Lori Perez is live at the corner of Santa Fe and Compton. That's one of the city's most popular spots for street takeovers, right, Lori?
That is right, Pat. And let me show you what they're trying to do here in Compton. We have all seen these on the freeways. They're called bots dots. You can see the Public Works Department here has laid them in a cross across this intersection. The aim is to make this popular street takeover corner bumpy, so it's unappealing for anyone looking to do burnouts or donuts. Street racers looking to pull this or burn that will soon run into a literal bump in the road if they try it at some Compton corners, where city leaders are hoping these bots dots will stop would-be stunters in their tracks.
It's all fun until something happens, you know. It's all fun until somebody gets hurt, and then there's candlelight visuals, and then there's, you know, GoFundMe's.
Councilman Andre Spicer shares concerns about a growing number of street takeovers in the city. He says Compton spent just over $4,000 to get enough of these raised pavement markers for four intersections. By the end of the week, he says they'll be in place at the city's most popular takeover sites: Santa Fe and Compton Boulevard, Wilmington and Caldwell, Long Beach and Alondra, and Wilmington and Stockwell. But Spicer says the dots are just one part of a street takeover solution.
I think that it's a combination of that and the proper response from law enforcement. I don't want to make it a you versus us. I don't think that they're bad people. It's just young people that are, you know, might be a little misguided. Some sound a little entitled. Unfortunately, the story has been that, you know, go to Compton because Compton won't do anything about it.
Until now. In Hyde Park, at another sideshow hotspot, local leaders are taking note.
That sounds like a good idea.
As they've seen a summer of street takeovers themselves.
It's like the fear of injuring themselves or somebody else that does not exist.
Now, Councilman Spicer says already some in the car community are mocking them, saying these dots will not stop them. But he says it's worked in places like Paramount and Linwood, so they're going to try it. And if it works, they will expand the program. If not, they are willing to try something else here in Compton. In Compton, I'm Lori Perez. Back to you.